There's some awesome level design in Super Mario Galaxy, where you can walk around planets with their own gravitational attraction, letting you walk upside down and travel from one planet to another. By taking advantage of Godot's powerful physics options, creating this style of 3D planet is way easier than you would expect. This mechanic has two parts: the planet, that applies gravity to the character when it's near one of them, and the character, that moves around planets and gets attracted to them. For the character, we'll use a rigid body to rely on Godot's built-in physics as much as possible. For the planet, we need two key nodes: a static body to walk on, and an area. The area handles all the complicated math involved in attracting the character. For the planet, we make a static body node with a spherical mesh instance and a matching sphere collision shape. We then add an area and a sphere collision shape for the area of gravity. You want to make it larger than the mesh instance. This is the area in which the character will fall towards the planet. There are a few properties to tweak on the area. We need to enable gravity point, making the area act as the center of gravity for our character. The gravity vec property determines the position of the center of gravity. So let's set it to 000 to center it. Change the space override property to replace. It makes it so that any body that enters the area uses it as the source of gravity. Lastly, you can increase the strength of gravity itself with the gravity property. I added two of these planets to a scene with a camera capturing both of them. I positioned it so that the gravity areas overlap. This way the character can jump from one planet to the other. We need a capsule collision shape and a mesh for our player's body. Thankfully, we have a body mesh and animations already made and ready to go. Now we need to set a few properties for the rigid body. Using the character mode keeps the character upright, preventing unwanted rotations. To detect collisions, we enable contact monitor and set contact reported to at least one. This detects when the player is standing on the floor. Moving the character along the planet's surface comes with two little challenges. We need the player's controls to be relative to the character, and we need to orient the character to the planet as they move. All the player's movement happens in the integrate forces virtual function, which is unique to rigid bodies. Like in 2D, we first calculate the player's input direction. We then use the xform function to turn the vector to face the same way as the model. Xform is shorthand for transform. It applies an object's transform to a vector or another transform. We move the player in this direction using the rigid body's add force function. To align the model with the movement, we calculate a basis. That's a matrix with three vectors, representing an orientation in space. We already have two of the three vectors: the gravity, which we get from the function state parameter, and the move direction, xformed to the character model. We calculate the third using the vector cross product. The function returns a vector perpendicular to the two we pass as inputs. The target character alignment is a basis made of those three vectors. The final step is to use the spherical lerp function to have the character turn smoothly. To jump, we first check the character is on the floor. The contact monitoring that we set earlier can tell us if we're in contact with a surface. To ensure we're on the floor, we loop over all the contact points and their normal every frame. The normal is the direction straight out from the surface. By comparing it to the gravity, we can tell if that surface is the floor. To compare the angle of vectors, we use an operation called the dot product. The more they align, the closer the return value is to 1. When the two vectors are perpendicular, the value is close to 0. If the dot product is, say, greater than 0.5, we can assume we're walking on the planet. When that's the case, and the player wants to jump, we apply an impulse in the opposite direction to gravity. And we're all set, with a character that can run around a 3D planet and even jump between them. Right now, we're on Kickstarter to fund Learn to Code from Zero with Godot. We've been working for months to make the course that we wish we had back when we started. It makes for a great gift to a loved one who'd like to become a game developer and helps the Godot community. Thanks to the funding, we're making a free and open source app for everyone to learn Godot's GD script right in their browser. You can back the campaign to make this a reality, get the course at a lower price, but you only have until October 31st. So check the campaign now over on Kickstarter.